Hello guys, in this video we will watch a game of Korean Challenger Varus. He got new lethality build on Varus, and with these items, he literally one-shot enemies. He's really so broken in this patch, so guys, I really recommend to watch this video to the end. And now, let's go! Okay, this Varus will play on bottom lane with Janna, against Aphelios and Lulu. It will be a very interesting matchup, because Varus is very strong in the early game, and it will be very interesting how he will release his advantage on the lane. Now let's concede that then in the tree bush, and they try to trap these two people, and Aphelios lost his heal, so it's good trade. And now Varus can farm this creep. He got all creeps, so it's good. His rampage you can see below. Hail of Blades, Taste of Blood, Eyeball Collection, Ravenous Counter, Biscuit Delivery, Cosmic Insight, Attack Speed, Attack Damage and Armor. He started with Doran Blade and Health Potion. So it's classic build for Lethality Varus. Now he's trying to push this wave, because he wanna get level 2 faster than enemies. Now he got level 2 with Janna. So these two people can do anything, and they will just farm under tower. That's cool. And also he can pull with his Q and E these people under their tower. So it's really very cool. To play on Varus so easily, you just need to stack your stacks on the W. Just 3 auto attacks, and after that you can use your E or Q, and it will deal a lot of damage. And after that you can do it again and deal again insane damage if you're passive. So the best combo for Varus is 3 auto attacks E, again 3 auto attacks W and Q. It will deal insane damage to the enemy. So with this combo, Varus will deal a lot of damage to the enemies, and this really, in the early game, it's really so insane and huge damage. So Koreans like Varus, because he is very strong in early game, and in Korea it's so important to get early advantage on the lane. And now Adam is trying to wait with Janna, because she had low HP. So this Lulu with Aphelios trying to trade with them. Lulu still trying to kill this Janna, and Janna used her. Oh, she will die, yes, she died, but Aphelios, oh. Oh, she. Varus killed this Lulu and Aphelios, oh my god, man. This Q combo to the Aphelios and double kill for Varus. It's good trade. He got double kills, and as I said, he stacked his passive. Not at 3 stacks, but in a way he deals some auto attacks, he stacks some passive, and it deals a lot of damage to the enemy. And also this Diana tried to gank, but she without flash, so she can't do anything. But it's bad cause this wave views, she will freeze this wave and it will be so bad. And Varus and Janna don't wanna let her to freeze this wave, cause Varus will lose a lot of creeps and Aphelios can freeze this lane. But look at this, they try to trap this Aphelios, Janna hit her Q and they deal damage, and this one shot damage to the enemies. But Aphelios finally got this Varus. But anyway, it's so good for Varus, cause Aphelios died, he will lose a lot of creeps, and he will lose also experience, so it's so important. And Varus with advantage, he got serrated York and Tear with boots, so with these items he have much more damage, and I wanna see how he destroyed this Aphelios again. Oh, he coming for mid lane. You wanna help to try to kill someone. Oh, there was Lulu. And look at this. Can I keep try to kill this Lulu? And maybe someone will help. Also enemy Akali got Sylas. But there also was Diana, so. And Polypyr tried to catch this Lulu, and Lulu just popped with this damage from Varus. So okay, it's fine, but I think it's not good, cause Varus lost a lot of time and he got only assist, so it's not good, cause in this time Aphelios got a lot of creeps and Varus lost a lot of creeps under his tower. But look at this, Aphelios won a true fight under enemy tower. And this damage from Varus, as I said, Varus is very strong in early game, so even Aphelios with heal can duel this Varus without heal. So now you can see this disadvantage for Aphelios, cause he is not strong, but he is not weak in the early game. But Varus is so strong in the early, and this is why Korean players wanna get early advantage. Varus now got this Aphelios and he died again. So it's so important, cause now he has advantage. And with Janna, he can try to kill this Lulu or something another again. Look at this. Volibear will try to kill this. Whoa, this Varus ultimate to the Lulu. And Volibear ultimate to the Aphelios, and he again just died. So this was so huge. And now Varus will try to get these plates. So it really so cool. Look at these 6 kills on this miner. It's so insane. Now he got one plate and he'll need to recall to the base, cause he got a lot of golds in his stash and he'll now buy some item. He'll now spend this gold to get advantage. So now he just waited on gold, I think. Yeah, he waited for gold. Now he got Vampire Scepter and Ivanian Boots. So it means he wanna buy Eclipse instead of Draktar. It's, I think, good choice, cause he playing against Diana, Akali and Jace. Diana with Akali has insane damage, they assassins, so they can just pop this this Varus. So with Eclipse, he has some shield and it can save him against these two people. It's not huge like Immortal Shibo, but anyway, it's some defense item, so it can be good against them. And he wanna buy this Eclipse. Oh, this Aphelios still trying to fight. I think it's a bad idea for Aphelios. And now this Varus just popped this Aphelios. He stacked his passive, as I said, use his E, I get passive Q ultimate. So it deals a lot of damage. His passive in early game deals so much damage. Also in late game also deals a lot of damage. So this Aphelios just died again. But Varus lost his heal, but it's fine. Because Aphelios again lost a lot of creeps. He died again. And Varus now got 7 kills, so as I said, Varus got early advantage. He got 7 kills and this Aphelios just dying again and again. Cause this Varus has advantage and he can kill him again and again. And look at this, he tried to trap this Aphelios, and also there was oh my god. This flash from Aphelios to the tornado was so annoying. It was so close to dodge, to avoid this tornado, but she hit it and Aphelios again just died and he just chilling out in the earth. And now Varus 8 kills, he got a lot of plays, and in this time he's jungler with support trying to roam on middle lane onto Diana. Oh my god, it was so bad jump. But now, oh, she lost her flash. But okay, it's anyway not good for enemies. And maybe, oh, this Volibear, he jumped under enemy tower with his ultimate. His ultimate disabled this tower. And they anyway killed Aphelios and Diana again. And also, Volibear wanna kill this Lulu again. And in this time, Varus got bot lane first tower. And also Lulu, oh my god, this low and speed. And Volibear used his flash to get this Lulu, and he got it. Also in this time, Our Varus got tier 1 tower at bottom lane. This is first start, so it's a lot of gold. He got Eclipse, Warhammer, Longsword, and now he coming for mid lane to get these plates too. So it's so good, cause Varus now has insane advantage. And he can do what he wants. In this time, Janna tried to help to heal this Jace, but Jace is not weakened early. So this Jace just popped this Janna. Also this Janna with Imperial Mandate for additional damage. Interesting choice. And now he coming for bot lane, but there was Diana, so it's so risky to go. You're so fat, but enemy Diana still can kill you, even with Eclipse. But I think with Eclipse, he can try to trade with her. But anyway, Varus just ADC, so Diana can just one-shot him, even with this advantage. And in this time, Diana still can try to use her ultimate under tower. And Varus missed his ultimate, but Janna is her shield and ultimate. So okay, this Varus survived. But as I said, Diana still can try to kill this Varus. Don't need to play more safely. Because he has insane streak. If enemy will get this streak, it will be so bad. In this time, he with his team got this red buff and they try not to kill someone again. Varus coming to the middle lane and they trying to catch someone. Oh, this, oh my god, this damage to the Ophelios. He didn't expect this damage. This Q damage with W was really so insane. And as I said, he stacked his stacks on the W and used his WQ combo and it used insane damage to the Ophelios, so he just popped and he even didn't expect this damage and it's really unexpected. Now his team also got Acolyte bottom lane, so it's so good. And this game just so funny, and they still try to trap someone, but I think Lulu don't wanna go this way. And they will just farm. And in this time, Volibear will try to get bottom tower. So it's good. Oh, this duel between Jace, oh my god, this damage from Jace! Guys, did you saw this damage? Jace so broken. He won't duel against Janna and Volibear. Volibear fed Volibear. He had so much advantage and he anyway lost this fight. So guys, this Jace damage really so broken. It's really unexpected damage from Jace. So it's not good. Oh, enemy still trying to get this Paora, and she will die. No, she's her flesh. Yeah, she will survive. And maybe Varus with Volibear will try to catch someone. Janna can try to bite this Diana, but she don't wanna jump. And it's not good. But Varus just farming, he got now Mana Moon and again serrated Jerk for additional damage and now his Q deals, oh my god, these numbers, these insane numbers. And with this damage, Varus is really a monster. Now they trying to get this Herald for advantage and with Herald they can try to push middle lane or maybe top lane. Tier 1 and tier 2 towers still alive. So they can try to get this for additional gold, but I think it's better to use for middle lane we get this tier 3 tower and inhibitor. Or maybe side lane, bot lane. If they will get bot lane inhibitors, they can try to get nature, cause enemy will have to defend bottom lane. And in this time they can get this nature. And with nature they can easily end this game. Cause enemy can't clear this wave from nature. They have only Aphelios, but they can just pop this Aphelios with Varus damage. Oh, they use hero for top lane. So it means they wanna get these turrets. And maybe this also hero can try to hit this on tier 3 tower, but no. He don't wanna stay for this. And we will clear this hero. So on this time they just got 2 towers and they will use recall to the base. So he's fine, they will get items and with additional damage. Oh, look at this, he got Sepan's Fang against Eclipse from Jace, against Diana and Lulu. Not really good choice for Varus. And with this item it will work very well against this broken Lulu with her E. Her E gives for enemies a lot of shield. And it's really so annoying. Oh, look at this, Diana jumped in. But Varus gives a lot of damage to the enemies on Varus with Diana just pop. And now, double kill for Varus. And they still gonna kill this Lulu, but I think it's not good. Oh, there also was Akali, but choose your combo wombo on this Varus, but he survived. And he also got this Akali. So as I said, this Eclipse, he saved him from Akali. He got shield. And after that, Sivas used his pretty mate. But I think it's not important, cause this shield anyway saved his life. And as I said, Eclipse will be works very good against these two assassins. Akali with Diana will try to focus Varus. And Varus with this item can try to survive against them. So guys, if you play on Varus and if you play against assassins like Diana or Akali, you can get Eclipse instead of Draktar. Cause it also gives you AD, Lethality, but you also get shield and it can save you. So it will be very important. Draktar of course gives you more damage, but you can't deal damage if you dead. So it is a choice to get this Eclipse item. Now our Varus, he got another Serrated York and stopwatch, so it's so good. Also, he still without Muramana, he got only Manamune. So I wanna see this damage with Muraman. And I think with Muramana he'll deal so much damage to the enemies. In this time enemy trying to get the Sivas. But Sivas, oh my god, this kill, man. Oh my god. No. He has insane survival, insane sustain. But not enough damage to kill enemies and he just died for no reason. Oh, enemies jump. Oh my god, this pop damage to the enemies. Very good stopwatch, but he's alone there. And enemy Aphelios got insane streak, 1000 gold. But in this time, Volibear just one shot this Aphelios. Also, there was Fiora with Janna. They tried to kill this Jace. Jace dead, but Fiora dead too. Lulu will survive. No, Lulu died from Janna and finally Volibear got Akali, so it means they can try to get this nature, but they without Varus. So I think it's not enough damage. Cause enemy Diana can try to steal this. Yeah, they trying to get this very slow. But look at this, half HP is gone. And maybe they can try to get this. But this Diana coming. She tried to kill the Savas, but Savas with Zhonya. He saved, and also this Zhonya from Diana. And as I said, it's a bad idea. Because they has not enough damage to kill this enemies. What? Who's damage, man? This Aphelios just disappeared. Guys, oh my god. This Varus damage really is so insane. Look at this, now he got Muramana. And with this item, he's really so insane. He just one-shotted enemy Aphelios. Oh, look at this, his flash combo. And he tried to kill this. This polymorph. He had his Q. He wanted to use his Q on this Jace, but this broken polymorph from Lulu just blocked his spells and he just died from this Jace. So it was so close to kill enemies, but not enough. In this time, Savas tried to get this Diana, but there was also Lulu and Aphelios. No, enemy don't wanna go in this tree bush. It was really a good play from Varus, but he was alone, so he just died and he gave for enemies so much gold. So I think it's not a good trade. Because enemy now got really so much gold. But anyway, he has anyway huge advantage. And with this advantage, he still can try to end this game as fast as he can. Oh, this Volibear tried to start far, but Diana jumped very good. But and in this time, Akali tried to kill this Varus. And Varus, he survived. And also, this Aphelios tried to kill down our Varus, but he's dead again for no reason. So, this ace! Enemy got nothing! Full team alive, and full team just dead. So, enemy died for no reason. They got nothing, and it's insane. And now, his team will get Soul and Nashor. So, I think it's end for enemies. Cause this advantage is really insane. Cause now they with Nashor, if so, Varus will get much more damage items. And this really will be so bad for enemies. What you wanna buy? Very interesting. Oh, okay, he got Edge of Night. It's good against Diana, Akali, Jace. It gives you shield and health. So it's a really good item for Varus. Again, for survivability. Of course, if you're dead, you can deal damage. And with these items, you can try to survive against enemies. Now he coming for middle lane. Trying to push lanes with top lane and with bot lane, but Fiora died on bot lane against Jace, so it's not good. Oh, this Savas. Oh, but he died. But it was so beautiful how he killed this Akali with her ultimate. And in this time, it's a bad idea to fight because 4 people against 3. Varus, of course, he has advantage and he can try to great against enemies. But anyway, enemies, they are 4 and he's only with Shanda and Volibear. So it can be a bad idea. I think first need to poke enemies. Oh, this damage, man! He survived, so lucky! He survived on a 10 HP, this damage, guys. It's really some unexpected damage from Varus. He almost one-shotted this Aphelios, but he survived on 10 HP. And this Q from Varus. It's a bad idea, they just losing time for no reason. They should just push. Power make him work. And in this time, Akali. Oh, this Varus just popped. But he got Akali, Diana, and his team also got Aphelios, so only Luz survived, and now only Nexus alive. And guys, I think this is over for enemies. So guys, what do you think about Varus in this patch? I think with these items and this vitality build, he's really monster and he gives really insane damage. You saw this damage to the enemies, to the Aphelios. So guys, I think Varus in this patch is really machine. And he's very, really, really very strong. If you like this video, please, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Also, you can write a comment about new videos on another champions. And now, have a nice day and goodbye.